Yo. What is going on, my dudes? Welcome to Work in Progress, the daily video series where I document my studio practice as a full-time gallery artist while showing you, the lovely viewer, what it takes to get here and, more importantly, stay here along the way. That's right, friends. Talent will get you there, but character will keep you there. So today, it's time to freaking do the frame thing, bro. We finished painting the frame yesterday. I let it dry overnight while I did that horrendous plein air painting in the park. And today we're ready to like assemble it, dude. So I figure, like, let's not even waste time on intros. It's raining out, so I've still got my thing on. But dude, let's just get into it, man. Let's get into what we got going on right now. We're gonna put this frame together, so I'm very excited about it. And then we're going to upgrade the blanket system on the window. That's right, no more crusty old blanket. Now we've got some actual blinds that we're gonna put up. And if there's time, I'm going to, well, not really if there's time, if weather permits, I'm gonna go back out and do another round of that plein air and just keep working on that same piece, or I'm going to work on it here in the studio from a photo that I took. And then after that, we'll go see if we have any canvas waiting for us at home, which hopefully today is the big freaking day. In the meantime, let's scope out our frame. Walking over to the spray booth. There he is in all of his glory. Quick touch test. We are completely dry, 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 dry. And it's looking nice. So we'll walk it over. Dang it, brother, look at that. Look at that, my dudes. Okay, so like I mentioned yesterday, the basic plan for this guy is, you know, you see these white lines here? I just basically want to extend these guys past the border and just right along here. You know, it's not the craziest, it's not conceptually groundbreaking or anything like that, but it's a way to continue iterating on this series, which is, you know, what I'm discovering is a very enjoyable part of it. And, you know, finding new ways for me or for the series to just be fully expressed in its diversity of execution and, you know, conceptual vigor. Nah, vigor is not the right word. But we're trying to approach it from all angles is basically what I'm trying to say. And this is one such angle. I really enjoy like these framed works. I really enjoy working with these frames. I've done a lot of them in the past and they've been very successful. And I think this is just another way to, you know, again, just iterate upon this series and keep it fresh, keep it exciting. So I'm going to get out of my, you know, rain jacket thing and get everything set up and give this a shot. Give it the old college try. So let's get into it, man. Okay, dudes. So I've got my little apron on here so that I don't get dirty. You know, I've anticipated, since I don't have canvas and stuff like that, I've anticipated that I'm not really gonna get super dirty during these sessions while I'm waiting. So, you know, I've been kind of in my civvies, I guess you could say. And yeah, man, all good. But I'm working on, we've got the apron in reverse too, because no free clout, baby. We're looking for sponsors here. No free clout. So let's get this, let's look at what we got here, dudes. So we've got here the lines and hopefully that is nice and visible. So we've got that. And I'm just drying this brush off that I recently cleaned, and I've got my white paint here. And honestly, man, I'm just gonna go for it now. This is kind of a little bit know how well you can see that from there, but we are slowly moving across. See if I can get you even closer. And before I start filling in all the ridges, basically what I want to do is make sure that the line is moving straight across, or acrossed, as some people might say. There's a fly buzzing around, dude, and it's kind of a, it's either a fly or a mosquito, and it's just pretty horrendous, dude. I hear it. I really hope you guys can't hear it. It's so annoying. And just kind of like the line on the painting itself, we're not really going for like, you know, a perfectly straight thing. We're going for like, you know, just a good impression of what's going on here. Which I think we are achieving quite well. Let's get this guy down here. At this point, I cannot tell if it's a mosquito or a fly, dude, but it's driving me insane. Let's bring the camera over to this side. And repeat. So again, just making sure that we are moving cleanly across. Very nice. Okay. Hell yeah, bro, look at that. That is looking good. I think the only thing that it needs at this point, I need to like come back in with white oil paint and just kind of like saturate that a little bit more, because it's not as opaque as the acrylic is sitting on there. So that can use some zhuzhing. So let's zhuzh away, bros. Okay, we got some white. Yeah, that's definitely the way to go. This was definitely the way to go, brothers. Also, if you're a girl, you're also a brother. Just, I use that in a gender neutral kind of way. Don't want people to think that this is a bro channel, although, shit, let's face it. Close my studio door. Yeah, that's looking a lot better, my dudes, because it's like, it's just a bit more like consistent across. Yes, sir. Well, shit, dudes, this to me looks freaking good as hell. Look at that beautiful crisp line. That works, baby. That works. So let's photograph it now. Okay, so normally, before I send this out to, you know, for the show, I'm gonna put some proper mounting hardware on the back. But it slipped my mind and I didn't get any when I was at the store. So for now, I'm just going to use a little bit of duct tape. And what I'll do is just basically use that as a temporary mounting thing to keep the canvas itself connected to, dang it, I keep ripping this weird, connected to the frame. Doesn't have to be perfect, it's just temporary. You can give it a quick flip over. And yep, that's looking good. Got a little bit of oil on here, so clean that off. And off it's going. Very easy. Good. Thank you. So now we can hang it. Oh, and by the way, look how nice.
Look how nice these hands look, dude. Now after they've dried and stuff. Look at that. Nice and articulate. Okay, so yeah, now we're gonna bring this guy over, and I have a little area here.
Look at that, my dudes. So beautiful, so clean, so profesh. Look at the dweetails. Look at those dweetails. Boom, 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 boom. Extendo, extendo. boom, 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 straight across, boom, boom, boom.
Hell yeah, dude. All right, so now I think what we can do is pop this guy into Photoshop and get him edited up. Yeah, let's do that.
All right, let's open these guys up. Open up this file and see what we got here. Man, this looks great. These are a great row. I'm having a hard time deciding on which to use. Kind of like that one. It has the several shadows on it. Yeah, we'll go with that one. Open it up in PShop. And it just looks so nice. Let's see what happens if I apply the previous settings. Oof, too cold. And, you know, I've got a good view of the painting from here, so it makes it easy to judge the true color. Down the exposure. If I bump the exposure up enough, all of the shadows will go away, which isn't the worst thing. 15 contrast. Let's see what it's like at zero. Yeah, that's pretty good there. And then the optics is good. Now once I import it, once I import it again, because otherwise you can see it's just a background and it's locked and you can't really manipulate it or anything. You can unlock it and move it around, but you won't have access to the original file again. Like, so whenever I import this, it's got the little smart object icon there, and I can double tap and come back and make any edits as necessary. But look, check it out, man. I mean, we've got good deets on it. It's looking good. Very happy. And so this guy we will enlarge it. And then here we can choose how much of, you know, shadow or background we want to allow to show through. I don't think too much is necessary, but I don't want to crop it all the way to the thing either. That looks pretty great. I'm gonna see if it might look better with one of the much closer one. Otherwise, I'm just keeping that one. But here we can apply the previous settings again. Do zoomies. The zoomies on this one looks better. Let's see though. Got something right here. Is that on the previous one too? Yep, it's there as well. So to make them line up perfectly, what I can do is turn my ruler on, it was already on, and then I can bring these guides up to the edges here. And now I'll know that if these line up here, it will line up with the others. So then we'll do the zoomies test. Yeah, you see the second, this one is just a tad bit sharper. So I'm gonna go with this one. And then what I'm gonna do next is make a duplicate and hit J, which is the shortcut for the spot healing brush tool. I'm gonna tap it and it's gonna give me a notification that I need to rasterize the smart object, which is fine. Just means that this icon goes away and now we can't go back and make any edits, but we've kept a copy regardless for that reason. So if we do, we can just repeat the process, no big deal. And I'm gonna make a mark here, or I'm gonna make the diameter of the brush itself as close to the diameter of what I'm working on, just so that there's not a whole lot of change. Just give it one little tap and that's it, it's gone. And if I toggle between the two, you'll just see there it is and there it goes. Boom, brothers, look at that. So we're gonna save this guy. Go to desktop, practice makes perfect. And then this is number 12. So I'm gonna title this Practice Makes Perfect 12. And then it's gonna ask me to replace it, which I'm gonna. Okay, well maybe it doesn't, maybe that's for a reason then. Maybe that's for a celestial reason. So I will go back over. And then I'll put 2 because it's the second iteration of it. Saving. Hurry up. Right, come on now. Okay. And then we've already got a Practice Makes Perfect 12-2 on there. So if I come back over here to Practice Makes Perfect Unit London, 12-2. Okay, see, that was the second version without all the brushwork. So I'm gonna retitle this one 12-3. So that 12 is not taken up anymore. And I'm gonna title this one Practice Makes Perfect 12. Save it as a JPEG.